ET, you know what I'm saying? The Galaxy, 3 to 7 p.m. every day, Monday through Friday. You can check me out, you know what I mean? Download the iHeart app, by the way. But we are here because we wanted to have an intimate setting with, you know, a person I believe deserves like a second chance. I know the reality star and all the stuff on television, you see that person, you be like, is that really them? And it's like, there's more to them than just that. And just listening to her rehearsals, I ain't gonna lie, I didn't know. I don't know about you guys, but I didn't know. I was like, she can really sing. I was like, shit, I didn't know. So we're gonna invite out Miss Johnny Blaze when she comes in the building, man. Please clap your hands as loud as you can so she can perform and do this thing for you guys. You guys ready to see her? Yeah. Miss Blaze, Johnny Blaze, can you come in here, baby girl?
Damn.
How you doing?
Hi.
You good?
Yeah.
Oh, that's your I'm gonna step off the stage and let you do your thing. Is that okay?
Sure.
I don't even want to take up this time with you, girl. So do your thing.
Hi, everyone. Hello. My name is Japelle. Some of y'all know me as Johnny Blaze. And today we are going to go through some of the songs that is from my album called The Naked Truth. These are two-year-old songs, and I'm not going to get emotional today because it's a big day for me. God got me. That's all that matters. Amen, amen. I'm super excited for you guys to come here and listen to the music that I have because I took a lot of time and patience and a lot of tears, a lot of passion, a lot of dedication to this music. So it's not just something that, oh, I just want to sing. I woke up and said, oh, I just want to sing. I've been doing it since I was 6 years old. I'm 27. 90? Yeah, 27. Okay, so the first song that we are going to play is called Love Me. I didn't love myself for a long time, and I just started to love myself recently, probably like 5 months ago. And actually, it was before that. It's actually 2 years ago, tripping. So when I did this song, I thought about, hey, what do I love? What do I want to do? What do I want that I never had? I never had a Louis bag. I've never had a Gucci bag. I've never had expensive shoes. So I made this video to make it seem like the things that I want and admire and want so bad when I get there. So I know all of us have done that before where we dreamed of things we wanted. So it's like you love yourself. Like, what makes you happy? Shopping for family or taking care of them. That's what makes me, you know, love others and love myself and all that great stuff. So we are, I wish this was a chordless, because you know I'll trip in a minute. But so now, are you ready, Dr. Waffles? DJ DJ Waffles, I'm sorry, y'all. There's a lot going on in my mind, but I'm so excited for y'all to be here. So let's get it. Thank you. No. Hey.
Okay, classic.
And I don't feel bad at all. Screaming out like, fuck the world, nothing matters to me no more. You want me to do it for you, baby?
Yeah, I know.
It's something I can't do, baby.
Yeah,
that's why I bought all the Louis to match up my diamonds and pearls. That's why I bought all the Gucci to compliment all of my furs. Yeah, but you know I'm amazing. You can bend down to my greatness.
Show up.
Feel like I need to be pampered. After I might hit the strip club, maybe I wanna see me a dancer. You want me to do it for you, baby?
Yeah, I know.
It's something. for how I walk, yeah. Looking around on the prints on the ground. Meanwhile, I'm stumbling in the club. I'm wasted. I don't give a damn about what nobody's thinking. Oh,
show up, turn up, show up.
To explode it, Johnny P the name, flow so retarded, shit so cold, shit so cray. Never be a bitch to take my lane. I'm on this one, gone so loony, chalk to the zone with a snapback and hoodie. Came from the gutter, but they all want something that they own. Houston's my home. Ah. Hey, yeah, I love me some me. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. So
hey, I want to. Can I ask you a couple of questions?
Yes.
I want to know because.
Can I have a seat? Because I
actually yes.
For
you know
stuff.
What? Hold on. Let me go ahead and get that seat for you. Someone over there.
I'd rather have a black one if it's okay. Thank you.
That's Gabe right there, you guys. It's a seat man. Have a seat, baby.
Have a seat, darling. Have a seat.
First of all, thank you for coming up here. Thanks for being a part of this and thank allowing you. Us to just be, because this is an intimate thing.
Yes.
And I know how difficult it is to be in front of, you know, a smaller crowd.
Oh,
and
I love it. I don't care if it's two
people,
yeah,
but you know,
honey.
Sometimes being in front of a smaller crowd is actually harder than being in front of a big crowd.
Oh, no. I love it.
Okay. So
I done been to places where I performed and it's only two people there, literally. And
well,
I just
and that's
my
why
heart
you do
out.
What you do.
Yeah.
So talk about, I want you to, what was the changing moment that decided for you to like, you know what, I need to love myself. Sometimes people reach a point and whatever that point is what makes you change. What was that point for you?
I recently had tried to kill myself, right? And I was a really, really bad drug addict. I took a whole ball of cocaine and ate it and passed out. Like, I don't remember waking. I woke up in the hospital.
Okay.
And I just was like, I hate myself. Like, why am I here? You know, and I was going through a lot. My boyfriend, 2 years before that, had died in front of me. Went on Love and Hip Hop, and they weren't pushing my music. They wanted the drama. And it's just like, I messed up in front of 16 million people every Monday. They didn't see the music. I feel like I failed at life, and I just don't want to be here no more. So when God gave me another chance at life, I slowly started loving myself, and I really just started like really loving me and being like, oh, I like my funny
when,
look.
When you say God
I like
gave
my funny
you...
looking toes, I like my weird ass ears, and
right?
My big thick body. Like I used to hate being thick.
What was that you know? Chance though that He gave you? Like what was it that was like, you know what, this is the point that I have to change? What was it?
I met Deb.
Miss Deb.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I met her, and she stuck with me through everything, like the ups, the downs, the being homeless, the should I strip for extra money, or what should I do, or I don't know what to do, or are they going to put me back on TV? And she just structured me to be like, you got to get it together. There should be no reason why that you shouldn't love yourself when you're so talented and you move people with your voice. So I was just like, you know what? Let me start slowing down on stuff.
Before you walked in, I had told them, I said, you know, just to be honest with you, you know, I've been around this industry a long time, since I was a kid. And Miss Deb, I've known her for a long time. My mother is an opera singer. Most people don't know that about me. So I've been around classical music and stuff like that. So when people say they can sing, to me, I'd be like, okay, let me see what you really can do. I don't believe it. But you can, you're actually a fucking singer. You know what I mean? Lessons came along with that, or was that something that was just in you? Or
I started when I was six.
Okay.
And I used to bang on a piano my grandmother had, and she used to beat me for doing it. So when she went to work, I used to play on it. By the time I turned like eight, I played the fair at least. I ran to the like piano on Christmas, and I was like, I gotta show grandma something. And when I played, they never let me off. So I went from acoustic guitar, bass guitar, the violin, the clarinet, the drums, the piano, and I just heard by ear and I started playing. Then my grandfather always had us in church, so y'all know how that goes. And I was like the youngest kid singing like an alto 1-2, soprano 1-2. And I never took lessons until recently with Brandon, which is Dev's son.
Mm-hmm.
And it just was my passion. It's been there. Obviously, God gave me this gift for a reason where, you know what I mean,
it never went away. My voice and my talent never went away, so I have to use it. I have no choice. I feel like that's what God wants me to do.
When you felt all
alone. He placed me here.
Yeah, well, when you felt all alone and people start hearing your songs, how many people come to you and say, I can relate to that?
A lot of people, and it was so crazy to transition from the dancer, the video vixen, the this, this, and that, she dated this person, to now when I see people, it's like, oh my God, I love that snippet, that 15-second snippet you have on Instagram, and I'm like, oh, this is dope. This is so cool. I don't think people know how it makes me feel, them talking to me or liking me or whatever I'm doing with music. It makes me feel like so excited, so freaking dope. It's cool.
Now that you're being more successful, is certain things that are failures easier to deal with now?
I love failures. I think that's what makes people. If we didn't have any type of negativity or any type of failures in life, it's like it would be a perfect world. And the world's not perfect. So everything that I went through, I love that I went through it, from, you know, just the drug abuse, the being snatched up at 14, prostitution, had no choice because I was forced to do it. You know what I mean? Got out of that, went to stripping, video vixen, being away from my mom. Like, if all that, I would do it all over again.
Does anybody out there in the crowd, if it's okay with you, have a question that they want to ask? Hand in the air, nobody? Hit it, Keith. Nobody.
Nobody.
Y'all good? Y'all just like, no, E.T., just keep on talking.
Nothing. Y'all just want more music, huh? You want, y'all just like sing.
That's DJ Nikki Nice right there. She's from Alabama.
Hi.
Hold on, let me come over there.
I can't see. So if I'm squinting, it's really because I really
it's okay.
Can't see.
She's.
I'm so sorry.
She's a fellow Thickum.
Hey, Thickum.
Hey, Thickum.
Hi.
Okay, so my question is this like your first album, or have you released any mixtapes or any other songs, or like how many times have you been in this road?
This is my first time in this room. Thank you, God. My first mixtape was May 16th that I've released, but I've always been releasing music, like, constantly. But this is my first album being released, and it means the world to me because it's like, this is what y'all are going to see. This is what you're going to portray me as. This is what you're going to think of me as, like, oh, is she R&B? Is she hip-hop? Is she techno? Is she EDM? Is she classical? Is she jazz? You know, so I'm nervous and I'm excited. So, yes, this is my first album, which I'm so excited.
I'm gonna. You know, ask that you bless the audience with another song, if that's okay with you. I'm going to run out and run back in here.
Cool.
And act like I'm going to put my voice on the radio, act like I'm in there when I'm not.
Okie dokie. Okay, so the next song is called Sharpshooter featuring TK Kravitz. That's the one that's sung 3 times in a row. Space, he has out recently. He's so dope. And we did this record 2 years ago. Everything is like 2 years ago, so... I hope you guys like it, and let me put this chair, because you know I'm a little clumsy. I had dancers, but they're not here, but it's okay, because the traffic, so it's not their fault, so I'm going to do a little something. You know, I'm thick or whatever, so I can't do too much. Are you ready, Waffles?
Fucking crazy, I run up a check in these clubs lately. Boy, I like it when I call ya daddy, baby.
Yeah.
Everywhere I go,
it's just me and the shooter.
All night.
It's just me and the shooter.
Can't no one compare
with me and my shooter.
It's just me and my shooter, me and my shooter. It's just me and my shooter.
She's sexy, but don't let it fall out.
She the real one, she represent that clip. You better know who you fuck around with. She don't play around by her bag. She don't play no.
Boys
say I dried them
fucking crazy. I run up a check in these clubs lately. Boy, you like it when I call ya daddy, baby. It's just me and my shooter, me and my shooter.
I believe we have Q&A. We're going to go into the next one. Elephant Mind. Okay, so I did this record with Elephant Man. I was like, hey, Elephant Man, you want to do a record with me? He was like, yeah, man, I'll do it. So I did the record, and I'm so excited about it. And, yeah, it's called Where You Come From. So y'all think I can't see you, but Mooney, bring them up to the front. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm about to get in your ass when I get off here. I see you. I love you. Are y'all ready? Y'all ready? Okay, cool. Let's get it.
Elephant alongside Johnny Blaze. You know me, I come from the West. Love me. Then she said,
rude boy. Yeah. Tell me where you come from.
Jamaica.
I'm a big body girl. Tell me, do you want some? I can feel your. Tell me where you come from. Tell me where you come from. I can wind it up. Take control of all. Let me slow it down. I can back it up. Jack in the box, dirty wine. Now come put your body on mine, on mine. Like an info, let's cry, let's cry. Let's take our time all night, all night. One time, one time. Caribbean boy, tell me where you come from. Ha! Caribbean boy, tell me where you come from.
Girl, let me tell you where me come from. Yard man, yet I'm a Jamaica. With your proper Addy slogan. Make your bum fast to a slow jam. Girl, me think
could you turn it up some, please?
That the body where you have up me with. Tell you talk on it where you have underneath. Couple round people to me repeat.
Never wanna leave you.
Wine pon the bamboo. Yeah. Come drop it on a real hard man from sea. Watch it there, when she do the body there. Yeah. Tell me really like how your wine pon the head. Hot like a inferno. Want you on me bed. Waft it with your hand. Turn up. Turn your body red. She say,
I know you want me to touch you. Feel you. Oh yeah.
Q&A? Any questions? I got answers. Hi, E.T.
I made it.
You made it.
I had to record a couple of breaks, and now everyone thinks I'm on the radio, and I'm not. I wanted to spend time in here with you guys. I missed the song. Was it good, y'all? Is anybody else, show of hands, is anybody else like shocked? Or y'all know she could do this?
You knew?
Y'all knew? So come a couple of y'all. I'm late. Sorry, I'll admit it, bro. Sometimes, let me tell you something, bro. The day and age that we are a part of, radio and everything else, is like there's so much music out there and there's so much people doing things. It's easy to miss stuff like that. I'm just sorry that I missed it.
It's okay.
I'm glad. I'm catching on late though, so that's all
I'd
that matters.
I'd rather people figure me out like when they
now.
Yeah. Rather than be like, oh yeah, I know. I mean, it's good that they know. Like some people that know, but when they don't know, it's like the funniest reaction.
Well, you know, you gain fans when you gain them. I think sometimes I was watching Ellen's show. Y'all seen Ellen's show before? And she said she became a fan of Nas with one mic. That was the first time she had ever.
Yeah, he's dope.
But that was her introduction to him. So your introduction is your introduction whenever it happens.
Yeah.
You recently called me for a gym. Are you gonna take up the martial arts of that now? Or what are we doing? You know what I mean?
I'm going to cheat.
You went to give
Man,
me some. Give
I
me.
Went there. No, give I, me went, some. I went there, right? And he was like, yeah, this is what you're gonna be doing. Yoga. I was like, okay, I could do yoga. Boxing, okay. Kickboxing. Then it was the where you gotta sit on the wall and go like
yeah,
this.
Oh the
yeah. No, I'm going straight to Dr. Miami. I'm not about to play with y'all. I'm not playing no more. I was like, y'all come back.
I tried. I got you. I got you when it comes to that. You know what I mean? So you've got this new chance on life. And some people always say that, you know, there's no second chances. And I've always said that. How can there be no second chances? There's no one that's ever not had a second chance at anything. Yeah. Where do you hope to see your music career go? I mean, is the goal for Grammys or is it just right
everything.
Now?
I think what artists don't say, they're like, oh yeah, I want the phenomenal records that people love. Of course I want that. I want timeless, endless music from 20 years from now. But I'm one of the modest people. I want to be rich. I want to take care of my mama. I want to take care of my family. I want to do humanitarian work. I want to give back to little girls that also been in my situation. Mm-hmm. I don't want to be no bougie girl. I'm like, oh, I just want to be. No, I want it all. I want the fame, the lights, the action, the running after me because they didn't love this number one record that's on the Billboard, me picking up a plaque and thinking my mama in a fur $10,000 coat. I want it all, you know? So that's what I want in life, just to be a big superstar and just to give back. Like, that's me. That'd be dope.
You now being in the ATL and stuff. Where are you originally from?
I was born on Moody Air Force Base in Valdosta, Georgia, and I lived a lot of places because we moved a lot.
Right.
So yeah.
Is this
home?
It's your home.
But before here was New York and then Houston. That's where I got popular at, and then I came here. Deb snatched me.
Miss Deb's out there. Just so you guys are aware too, Miss Deb is out there right now. Did you guys see Miss Deb on TV before?
Y'all know who Deborah Ann is. Can we get a round of applause for Deborah Ann, please? Thank you.
She's out there right now cracking the whip. Yo, y'all get this food ready right now. I'm not playing. She's out there cracking it. Y'all, hurry up. Let's go. So when y'all get out there, it's going to be all kinds of good food for you guys.
Y'all going to be like, where did this come from? From that truck? That
she's not playing at all.
She's so not playing.
Cracking the whip. So she's in this thing right now, man. Oh, there it is. Mr. Rhythm D is in the building. You guys know who Rhythm D is?
Hi.
You guys don't know who that is. That's a super producer right there. He did work with Eazy-E, NWA, Bone Thugs and Harmony,
Swag.
Snoop Dogg, Tupac. Damn, connection right here. You invite them all out right now. So what's the craziest? I do have a weird question. What is the craziest fan that's ever come across to you? Like someone you didn't know was like expect to be your fan. Like, damn, you like my music?
A lot of people. I had 2 Chainz stop my show. We were in Orlando, and I was performing, and I halfway finished because they messed up the music, and he told somebody to come here, and he was just like, I knew you for so long and never knew you sung. Keep doing your thing. And it shocked me. It could have been just anybody before you to do that, to stop my show and then be like, wow, like that really amazed me. It was really dope. So some of the artists that I work with, like T-Pain wrote a song for me. I would never think that would happen. TK wrote James, Black Youngster. Fetty Wap and me just did our second song, so that'll be on the album. Cherish and me did a song together. It's just like a blessing to see these people that you look up to, or either you see them in the spotlight and you're like, oh, you're noticing me, and that's a blessing. So I thought that was pretty cool.
Who's an artist that you're a fan of?
Sade.
Oh, okay.
Whitney Houston, Mariah Carey.
I was gonna say that you probably wouldn't be expected to be a fan of, you know what I mean? But
oh ma'am, I'm sorry, because when you say who you love, I'm like Sade. I'm sorry. Say the question one more time.
Who's an artist that you're an unexpected fan of? Like something that maybe in a different genre of music that people are like, yo, I'm actually a fan of this.
Kiss.
Wow.
Temptations. I like, you have to like all these types of music because, well, for me, because I do everything. I like country. I like, you know, smooth jazz. I like classical music. I like gospel, Mary, Londa Adams, Kirk Franklin. And I switch over Christina Aguilera, Britney Spears, but it's because of the performance. Britney and Christina performance is phenomenal. Lady Gaga because of the consistent work. Beyonce because of the consistent work. The voice. Jennifer Hudson. Then I might switch over to rock and roll. Like, I just, it's just different for me, you know? Like, I like everything. If it sounds good, I'm down.
I see the happiness in you now. You've accepted the fact that maybe you're not like everyone else, and that's okay.
Yeah. I mean, sometimes I have my moments where I sometimes get upset and just, because I love my passion for music means so much. So it's like, I feel like anybody around my camp should know that I love it that much to understand, you know, like, so yeah, I'm in a happy space right now.
It's like
I'm doing what I love.
We live in a world of categories, and for some people that don't live in categories where they just love them all, it's hard for the people to understand them, and I think that's probably, you know, been your most difficult situations in your life right now. But I know you have more music. You guys enjoying this right now?
Yeah.
We working you to death, girl.
No, it's okay.
Oh, come on, like, keep on working.
I would need a mic stand and a chair. Oh, shoot. So this song I wrote recently called Change, I notice when I have breakups or like somebody hurts my feelings or whatever, I tend to used to go off and stuff like that, but not no more. So I write about it. And a guy told me these words. What was that? A guy told me these words before. He used to take Adderall to stay up. So everything that he said, and he said, I'm going to switch my number up, act bougie on the weekend, flexing on my ex, yeah. So instead of that, when a man tells you these hurtful things, like I'm just not feeling you or I don't want to be with you or whatever, you take those words and you make a song. And for a female to say what a dude says is like the illest thing. K. Michelle does it. I hear Beyonce say it a lot, sing a lot like that. So the words are, I've been on Adderall lately. It's easy for me to switch on you. I know it's killing you, yeah. I'ma switch my number up, act bougie on the weekend, flexing on my ex, yeah. Riding around the city, you can stand near me, don't come round near me, yeah. You think making love to me will change me? It ain't making love if I don't feel the same. Why we wasting time doing the same thing when I already moved on? Yeah, I changed. Oh, I changed. I just don't feel the same. I just don't feel the same. Oh. Ready, Waffles?
Same thing when I already moved on. Yeah, I changed. Oh, I changed.
wasting time doing the same thing. But now I already moved on, yeah, I changed. Ooh, I changed. I just don't feel safe. I just don't feel safe.
I'm sorry, I'm goofy at heart, y'all, my bad. All right, so I can't see, that's why I'm really laughing. I'm trying to play it off and try to squint. So this song is called Body. This is probably Dub's favorite. I'm so glad she's not in here because she would have stole the mic and started singing. It's so hilarious. But, oh, she's about to, like, really come in here and be like, my body. It's funny as hell. My body was, I think I was just writing and felt it, and it was just like how you want a guy, or even if you want a woman really, really bad, and what you would say to them. So, oh, you read Tea Waffles. All right. You so know I'm a 90s kid. You could tell by the music. I'm such a 90s baby.
I want it in the morning and night. Just tell me the moves. I want them to know it's exclusive, but there's a limit to you. You've been running through my mind and I'm going crazy. Morning the millions, I'm telling them chicks don't face me. I can do for you more than a prototype, baby. Show you some things I put you on game, baby. Touching me like no other, baby. It's nothing like your loyal body. Oh, my body, your loyal body. It ain't no question, baby, damn right. I ecstasy fills the room. Hesitation, baby, on side. Want you to make me yeah. It's 2 in the morning, can't leave you alone. All this thinking about you, come give me some more. When I think it's enough, I'm right back at your door. You've been running through my mind and I'm going crazy. More than the millions, I'll tell you them chicks don't faze me. Get to find you more than a prototype, baby. Show you some things to put you on game, baby.
Q&A. Okay, so, Anthony, and the guitarist. I can't see, so I don't know where I'm looking at. Like, I'm sorry. So this is Anthony Beck, everybody, because we gave a round of applause. And his brother, Jeremy. So, he got you set up, look. Okay. So, these two boys are very, very talented.
Not lying. You really cannot see.
Yeah. Yo. Wow. I'm looking up and I'm like, man, I can't see, but it's okay. I can see y'all, but not really, if that makes sense.
Let me get this right. All
right. Let me know when y'all are ready. This is a dope song that... How we wrote this song was so funny. We met, he played guitar for me at... what magazine was that? Was it Tuck? No, it wasn't Tuck yet, because I haven't did Tuck yet. Shout out to Tuck magazine. It was another company, iMag or something like that. Yeah. So he had to play guitar for me, and I really liked the way he played guitar. I liked the sound. So I told him to come to the studio, and we sat on like the stairs, and we wrote this song in like 15 minutes, and it ended up being really catchy and dope. And then his brother plays guitar. I play guitar too, but I'd rather him do all the stuff and things. So this is called Interlude.
She said that living with me would bring the death to her. But I don't believe it so, no.
He said it's difficult for him to watch me go. I can't give you my love no more.
She makes it so damn hard to let.
He makes it hard for me to get over him, but I wanna let him go. I don't want our love to fade away, but I don't let him go.
Actually, Freedom was my first song. There was a song that I did, and Deb did not like it. She was like, that's not you. And I cried, because I'm like, oh my God, I flew down here, she might not like me, and now I suck at the music that I'm putting out. She's like, no, you're not talking about your story and your life. So this is the first song I wrote on my album. Well, Love Me was then this one, but this is the one that impacted me probably the most. And it's about not a boy, nobody, but my life of what I went through with my mom and just my life. And it's called Freedom. Are you ready? I was supposed to play it on piano, but I don't know where my piano's at. So I'll pretend. K-Classic. You gotta stand up for this one.
Okay.
was, made me everything I am. Judge me, but you don't know what I've been through. I've seen it all before, and I heard it all before. And I won't let no one take away from me. No I heard it all. Hey, yeah. Oh, oh, oh. Before, without you, no, I found my way without you. I found it, God, because always without you.
Thank you. So, I believe we're done. thank you. And thank you guys so much for coming. And please be honest and tell me what you think, what you like, what you think I should change, what you want to hear me sing. And I think we'll do Q&A out there. Yeah?